Hi, today I will dry my ASA filament using regular food dehydrator. I'm Medic 3D and I do a lot of 3D printing related stuff. Today I will dry my Terfuse ASA filament using a regular food dehydrator. When I was printing with it recently, I've noticed the popping sound, which means that it is not dry enough to print with a proper quality. So the only solution to that is to dry it. There are a few options to dry your filament. The easiest one is probably just to put it in your oven and set the right temperature and leave it like that for a few hours. Next one is to buy a fila dryer from Sunlo or similar product. And today I will make attempt to use regular food dehydrator and make my own filament dryer. This is regular food dehydrator and it costs about $25, which is half the price of the fila dryer. The food dehydrator consists of three parts: the base part, which contains the heating element and the fan, the plates, where you put all the food, and obviously the cover. And the important thing about the cover is that there are holes and the moisture can just go out. The easiest option to use the dehydrator to dry the filament is just to cut off the center side of the plates and put the filament inside and the cover on top, but I just don't want to break the perfect parts. So instead I will just print a brim all around the base, which can also accept the cover on top, and obviously it needs to a little bit higher than the regular plate, but the profile on this side and on this side should be exactly the same, so I can just stack it on top of it. So let's quickly design the part in Fusion 360. This is quite simple one. There are just two circles and you need to extrude them and connect somehow. Because my Prusa build volume is not big enough to print the whole part in one go, I split it into three parts. After designing, I've printed those parts to check if everything is alright. The sample prints looked fine, so I began to print the final design, and there it is, the three items. And the connector pieces just slides in. Now I need to just glue everything together. And it should be good to go. As you can see, the seam is not perfectly flush. Probably I need to redesign the connector, but it should be good enough. I can use the base, add single plate, then my 3D printed part, then the filament, and the cover on top of it. Now I am ready to start drying the filament, but first I would like to check how much the spool weighs right now. Then I can check it again after a few hours in the dryer. And also I would add a wattmeter and check how much power this dryer consumes, because I hope that this solution would take less power than putting your filament in the oven. So the spool right now weighs 993 grams. Let's check it again. This is zero. And again, this is 993 grams. Let's check it again. Zero. 993 grams. The testing setup consists of wattmeter, one hygrometer outside the dryer, and one inside it. After 4 hours and 40 minutes, I decided to end the drying. In this time, the dryer used 0.77 kWh. The hygrometer inside the dryer was showing temperature of 55.8 degrees C. Because there was a moisture inside it, I was unable to determine the humidity. Just in case, I flipped the spool and let it dry for another hour. Then I weighed the spool. It is 991 grams. It seems that about 2 grams of moisture was removed. And for the final test, let's print something. It is a success, there is no popping sound. First, I printed some calibration cubes, and after minor changes in my settings, I printed those parts. Those are parts for my next ANET-A6 upgrade to make linear rail x-axis. The surface is quite nice and the print quality is okay. I would say that for only $22 the results are pretty nice. Watch my other videos that are right here and there and tell me what next step should I take to improve my filament dryer, because the first option which came to my mind is to add a lazy Susan to enable printing while drying like so. The another option is to make another enclosure so I can print like so and insert filament stand in the upright position. And the last option is to take everything apart, remove the heating element, remove the fan, remove all the electronics and switches, and make everything custom from scratch. Use comments to share your thoughts.